What's up, y'all? I'm gonna show you guys how I set up my icing machine and I'm gonna tell you where I got it. It's basically a grow tent for plants, but you could use the same setup to ice your shoes. For those of you guys that already have this setup, you know, I don't want to know what y'all are growing, but I'm not gonna say no to a sample. So here's a quick look at my setup. I have two of the machines on top and I have this cube. I don't know if height makes a difference. I need to keep experimenting. If the closer it is to the light, the better results I get. And it could fit about four pairs at a time. I just wanted to see how many shoes it could fit in here. And here's this big turbine fan that pulls in cool air into the tent. So at the very bottom of the tent, it's a constant 67, 66 degrees Fahrenheit. And the reason why temperature is important is because you don't want your shoes to separate. So this setup was actually my first time trying out all of the equipment for the first time. I didn't know how big the grow tent was supposed to be. I didn't know if the lights I was going to use were even going to work. So you can see by these results, it works pretty good. The reason why I'm using a grow tent to house the shoes in, because it has this material that will reflect 99% of the light inside. You don't have to use this exact setup. You can probably get away with using a smaller grow tent if you don't want something this big. And the size I bought was 24 by 24 by 48. All right, so let's see how much this whole thing costs. We're also gonna check out how much electricity I'm going to be using up and the cost of that as well. Okay, so I bought two of the grow lights and that's gonna cost me $179.98. The cooling fan itself is about $65 and the grow tent is about $62. So the total is gonna be about $303.25. So if you start charging people $40 to $50, you'll get your investment back in full by your six pair of shoes that you commission. Now I do want to get into electricity costs. For my electricity costs, here is my plan. Just to make it easy and simple, I'm going to combine the two and average it out. So it's going to be about 34 cents a kilowatt. So how I calculated my electricity bill is I added the amount of watts that my lights use and the fan uses. So my lights produce 176 watts each. Since I have two, I have to multiply that by two. Adding the power of the fan, it's gonna total 419 watts. Now it really depends on where you live. I live in California, so electricity rates are pretty high. I know some states can go as low as 9 cents a kilowatt. Now the prices in the green box is what it would cost you if you would never turn off. Realistically, it's never gonna happen, so it's gonna be about a third of that price, if anything. But if you do end up not turning off the lights for an entire year, it will cost you, or it'll cost me, $1,250, but it'll only take me about, 21 pairs of shoes to ice to pay that off. So it's not that bad. And here are some of the other shoes that I tested this setup on. I got these 2000 Columbias, from a dark brownish orange to a lighter hue of blue. And same results with these 2000 Concords. I also use solid rubber soles for this project and it works just as good. You can also do Air Force One so they'll look.
Brand new Air Force, huh? Air Force One, huh?
And this is just 2 days in of the icing machine. They got significantly better. There's no more orange hue to it. It's a lot lighter, so I'm gonna keep going with these. Hope you guys learned something from this video. If you guys are about to do this, tag me on Instagram. I want to see your guys' results.